As the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven, as he resolutely set out for Jerusalem. He resolutely set out for Jerusalem. He resolutely set out for Jerusalem. To be taken up. He resolutely set out for Jerusalem. The Jesus resolutely set out for Jerusalem. As the time approached for Jesus to be taken up, he resolutely set out for Jerusalem. As the time approached for Jesus to be taken up. As the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven. As the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven. As the time approached for Jesus to be taken up to heaven. He resolutely set out for Jerusalem. 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 As they were walking along the road, he resolutely set out for Jerusalem. They were walking along the road. He resolutely set out for Jerusalem. As they were walking along, he resolutely set out for Jerusalem. They were walking. He resolutely set out for Jerusalem. He resolutely set out along the road. He resolutely set out for Jerusalem. He resolutely set out for Jerusalem. As they were walking along the road, he resolutely set out for Jerusalem. As they were walking along the road, he resolutely set out for Jerusalem. As they were walking along, he resolutely set out for Jerusalem. He resolutely set out for Jerusalem. As they were walking along the road, a man said to him, "I will follow you wherever you go." I will follow you wherever you go. As they were walking along the road, I will follow you wherever you go. As they were walking along, and said to him, "I will follow you wherever you go." As they were walking along, and said to him, "I will follow you wherever you go." As they were walking along,
Jesus replied.
Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests.
Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. Jesus replied.
foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. The Son of Man, no foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. The Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. The Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. But the Son of Man has no foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. But the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. Foxes have holes, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. The Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. To birds of the air have nests. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. The Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. The Son of Man has no way at all to lay his birds of the air have nests. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. But the Son of Man has no way to lay his head. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. No way to lay his head. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. Foxes have the Son of Man has birds of the air have nests. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. But the Son of Man, foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests. But the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head.
In the waiting room. In Worcester, Massachusetts. I went with Aunt Consuelo to keep her dentist's appointment and sat and waited for her in the dentist's waiting room. It was winter. It got dark early. The waiting room was full of grown-up people, arctics and overcoats, lamps and magazines. My aunt was inside what seemed like a long time, and while I waited and read the National Geographic, I could read, and carefully studied the photographs, the inside of a volcano, black, and full of ashes, then it was spilling over in rivulets of fire. Gosa and Martin Johnson dressed in riding breeches, laced boots, and pith helmets. A dead man slung on a pole long pig, the caption said. Babies with pointed heads wound round and round with string, black, naked women with necks wound round and round with wire like the necks of light bulbs. Their breasts were horrifying. I read it right straight through. I was too shy to stop. And then I looked at the cover, the yellow margins, the date. Suddenly, From inside, came an owl of pain and Consuelo's voice, not very loud or long. I wasn't at all surprised. Even then I knew she was a foolish, timid woman. I might have been embarrassed, but wasn't. What took me completely by surprise was that it was me, my voice, in my mouth. Without thinking at all. I was my foolish aunt. We were falling, our eyes glued to the cover of the National Geographic. February, 1918. I said to myself, 3 days and you'll be 7 years old. I was saying it to stop the sensation of falling off the round, turning world into cold, blue-black space. But I felt, you are an I, you are an Elizabeth, you are one of them. Why should you be one, too? I scarcely dared to look to see what it was I was. I gave a sidelong glance. I couldn't look any higher, at shadowy grannies, trousers and skirts and boots and different pairs of hands lying under the lamps. I knew that nothing stranger had ever happened, that nothing stranger could ever happen. Why should I be my aunt, or me, or anyone? What similarities? Boots, hands, the family voice. I felt in my throat, or even the National Geographic and those awful hanging breasts held us all together or made us all just one. How I didn't know any word for it, how unlikely. Point. How had I come to be here, like them, and overhear a cry of pain that could have got loud and worse but hadn't? The waiting room was bright and too hot. It was sliding beneath a big black wave, another, and another. Then I was back in it. The war was on. Outside, in Worcester, Massachusetts, were night and slush and cold, and it was still the 5th of February, 1918. Elizabeth Bishop. Jim McIntyre.
I took a drug called Levaquin. It's called a quinolone antibiotic. That was nearly 2 years ago. I've been on disability ever since. I must have over 40 different symptoms from this antibiotic. Neuropathy, nerve pain, tendon damage. I've had central nervous system damage to my brain. I've had brutal palpitations, anxiety, panic attacks, tremors, bouncy vision, floaters in my vision, tinnitus. I was the healthiest guy in the world before I took Levaquin. I was playing tennis, basketball, didn't have one health problem. I took Levaquin for a simple infection, and my doctor told me that Levaquin would cause me no harm. Ever since that day, I've been to 16 different doctors. Only a handful of doctors even acknowledge that this is even possible. When I picked up the prescription at the pharmacy, it never mentioned anything about irreversible side effects. The package labeling information just mentioned that it could cause pain, insomnia, things of that nature. but I never associated that with disabilities that could last for more than a couple days. As I mentioned, it's now been 2 years, and every single moment of every single day is a mighty struggle. I never want anybody else to go through the absolute unending horror that I have gone through for the last 2 years of my life. I'm not even sure if I can make it, as my strength to go on is growing weaker and weaker. It is so hard to get up every day to fight these symptoms. It's almost like I'm at war against my body every day. Hopefully someday I can recover. God bless. Is growing weaker and weaker. It is so hard to get up every day to fight these symptoms. It's almost like I'm at war against my body every day. Hopefully someday I can recover. God bless. Thank you.
It's not even another planet, it's just so odd. If there's life here. And there's millions of other planets out there. Shouldn't... There be life on Earth.
Yeah, but they don't have an
ozone layer, so they don't. mean there's billions of... There's billions of planets, but at least one of them. that's got to have
some
it.
Astronaut. Let alone.
We are one of a kind! You gotta come on, you guys. There's a has to be life on other planets. You cannot... not say, you can just not say no. Okay, there is life on other planets, like... They haven't come to us yet. What if we have to go to them?